And with that, we welcome you to the stand. Sheriff Center, the Hawaiian Tel FCU starting lineup, scrolling in the bottom right corner of your screen. The eighth-ranked Stanford Cardinal at 11-7 overall, 6-5, and currently in sixth place of the MPSF. Hawaii ranked fourth, 18-2 overall, 8-2 in the league, and riding a 13-match win streak. And right off the bat, an overpass is forced, and Kupono Faye pounds down the first point of the match.
Great decision by Henrik Moll to not hit that overpass. He got backed up further and further to about the 8-foot line. No percentage there in trying to kill it. Nice for him to pass up and run a play.
Jennings Franciscovich with the serve. Another overpass. This time it's Stein von Tilburg with the free swing, but it's returned. Stein a second time finds that end line, and Hawaii scores the two first points of this match.
Be able to stop Stein once, but rarely do you stop him twice in a row.
So once again, the setter Franciscovich to serve. Cardinal finally able to work transition. It's a block by Hawaii. It's a roof by Hawaii. Clay Jones denied access, and Hawaii quickly up 3-0.
Clay Jones is the hero last week at Penn State, picking up a bunch of kills in place of Jordan Ewart, who was out with a sprained ankle and not here tonight.
So already a kill and a block for Stein. Outside, the swing by Jones, this time plugs it through that proposed double block, and the Cardinals on the board. Stanford playing without their top hitter tonight, Jordan Ewart, 6'4 sophomore from Antioch, California, averaging 3.6 kills per set, out for the second weekend of action because of a rolled up ankle. Eric Beatty will serve. Good pass there by Faye. Back row set to Brett Rosenmeyer, and he's stuffed. And the 7-footer showing his work. The redshirt junior from Newport Beach, California, Kevin Rakestraw.
One of the places you don't want to hit is at the 7-footer. He gets an awful lot of blocks. You want to hit away from K-Rake, not into his hands.
Ah, yes, K-Rake. You can't coach 7 feet. Outside, it's Stein trying to go over the block, sends it long, and after 3 straight points to start the first set for Hawaii, the Cardinal on a 3-point run of their own. Eric Beatty, one of the freshmen part of this top-rated recruiting class for John Costi with the serve. Here's Faye on the opposite side, able to pound it off the block and out. And Hawaii jumps back up.
We're testing Faye to be sure. First 3 serves right at Kupono Faye to see if he's got any sort of passing skills. He showed that he does.
John Costi, head coach for Stanford, telling us prior to the match, the focus was on the pin hitters for Hawaii, if they could somehow contain them and slow them down.
Exactly. And win the serve pass game.
Well, so far not so good on that front. Another overpass, but Moll couldn't put it down. Good dig there by Tui Tui Leta. So Jennings outside to Rosie through the block and down. Brent Rosenmeyer averaging 2.18 kills per set, the sophomore from Virginia Beach, California. His high school teammate is on the Stanford roster. Not sure if we'll necessarily see much of him. Russell Dervais, he is one of the backup setters.
Richard Dervey did not make the trip. Would have been nice to have 2 Virginia Beach boys out there along with Josh Walker.
There's Vega. Holy moly, Hendrik Moll with a solo block on his 23rd birthday.
Well, the signs are out for Hendrik. The block solo. Great read by Hendrik Moll to get that, going to that block, the wrist away shot.
Did that against Gabriel Vega, an Iolani product in his senior year now for Stanford. Rakestraw, we got a net violation. It was a fantastic dig by Kupono Faye. It's a 4-0 net violation against Hawaii. Gives the point to Stanford.
And Kendrick Mulman a little over-eager on that one. Penetrated too much in that block.
So here's Clay Jones with the serve. Middle set, that's Kendrick Mulman.
Will birthday boy get a few more birthday sets tonight? That's the big question. Knowing Jennings Franciscovich, I think he will.
Well, one person who hasn't made a big deal out of Hendrick Mole's birthday, that's his head coach, Charlie Wade.
That's right.
We passed him prior to the match. Hey, what'd you do for Hendrick on his birthday? He says, when is it? And that'll be a point for Stanford. Give it a kill to Gobble Vega.
And then he followed up.
He said, oh, I got him a match against Stanford for his birthday. Who else would you want to play on your birthday? Charlie Wade asking him right now, are you sure it's your birthday? Five serving seven. Franciscovic outside. Rosenmeier through the block with one-handed dig in the back row there by Beatty. And then from that middle position, Stephen Moy, 6'9 Frosh from El Segundo, California, goes off the block and down.
Moy wants to be an orthopedic surgeon. Did that surprise you? Oh, that was your major, wasn't it?
Minor.
Is neurosurgeon the major?
Oh, the whiff on the middle set. So chance now for the Cardinal. It's Vega, pounds it off the block and out. And the Cardinal able to tie things up. Again, shorthanded without their top hitter, Jordan Ewert. But Gabo Vega out of Kailua, Hawaii, head coach John Koski saying he is finally starting to truly come into his own, and this is senior year. Middle set, that's Pat Gassman putting it down.
Gabo's had an interesting career at Stanford. In his second year, he had a concussion that held him out for an entire year. He never did get it right. He actually had to come back here for a quarter and just sit out of school completely because he had so many bad repercussions from that concussion.
Oh, big swing there from Eric Beatty. We're tied again.
Beatty, just a freshman, played on a two-time national high school championship team at Huntington Beach High School. Made first team high school All-American. There, I guess Hawaii's going to figure out, well, can the freshman really hit the ball? I think he can.
There's Rosenmeier. Misses the court wide. And all of a sudden, Stanford leads for the first time in this opening set. 5-1 run. Paul Bischoff, the setter with the serve. D-set. Stein unable to put it down. That's Evan Enriquez setting up the opposite hitter. That's Beatty. Gets the point. Stanford up two. Evan Enriquez, a 6'2 junior from the Big Island out of Kamehameha Keaau.
Pretty obvious that Hawaii's gonna get three blockers up. And how does Beatty find a way through? Well, there was one little sliver of a hole between Franciscovic and Gassman, and Beatty found that hole. Great set from Enriquez, by the way, from the back row. That was a tough set.
Enriquez and Vega, two local boys on this Stanford team, just sort of the latest generation to exploit that Hawaii to Stanford men's volleyball pipeline that has served John Costa and this program so well over the years.
In our pregame chat with him, he was almost bragging about the fact that, you know, we just love the Hawaiian connection. We love coming back here. We love recruiting players here.
Serve goes long. It's a point for Hawaii, and they needed that one. Stanford was starting to really gain some traction here at this juncture of the opening set. Yeah, John Costa actually referring to this road trip. He says it's like coming home. Charlie Wade's looking to make things much more uncomfortable than that. But Rosenmeier follows up the outserve with an outserve of his own. And now Gabo Vega will serve. Jump serve, two-handed in the air by Tuileta, and then dumped down by Jennings Franciscovic.
You don't see many liberos take jump serves with their hands. Tuileta is one of the few in the country who can do it. He can control the ball all the way up to the net so that Jennings Franciscovic can become the fourth hitter.
Jennings, who had to deal with a bout of strep throat earlier in the week,
missed two of the three practices.
Goes outside. Kukono Fei mistimed exchange there as Faye had to adjust the jump because of the set off the net, and he sends it long.
I think he expected a much faster tempo. He got in early and had to wait for it then.
So 12 serving 10. Stephen Moy floats it over. Faye goes way down with the pass. Back set goes to Stein, and he is roofed. Rake Straw next to Clay Jones.
Good block, 6'7 and 7 feet. Those are two big blockers. Those are as big a blockers as Steinberg's ever going to see all year long.
That does not happen very often to Stein von Tilburg. Hawaii trails by three. Another short float serve from Moy. Jennings swings on the second touch. This time sets up Kupono off the block and out. Kupono Fay very active here in this opening stanza, Chris.
You know, it's interesting watching this run to 15 here in the first set. We've been used to the streak that Hawaii's been on, and I don't think anybody's beaten them to 15 points that whole time. All of a sudden, Hawaii's behind the eight ball.
Rosenmeier able to pop that one up. Fay, the two-hand set, Rosie the tip. Cardinals with a chance here. Enrique, bump set, right side, and that's Beatty blasting it off of the hands and out. I mean, this has been a streak of epic proportions for this Hawaii team. They've won 13 straight matches, swept the last seven. They've won 26 straight sets. But right now it's Stanford up three, threatening to be first to 15, as you mentioned. Oh, boy. Brett Rosenmeier with a hammer.
Hitting the back row quick. My goodness. What a swing, great set from Franciskovic, great pass from Larry Tuileta.
Showing a little explosion there, Brett Rosenmeier. It's Kupono Fay now back behind the service line. And he misses the court wide, so we got the timeout on the floor. Stanford leads at the turn, 15-12, and the Cardinal feeling real in the opening set. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match. C-Mac.
Well, for Stanford, it's a 10% rule. When your top star and big point getter, Jordan Eward, goes down with an ankle injury and misses the trip, the rest of the starters need to produce 10% more to make up for that loss. And for Hawaii bench, you better be ready with Jennings, Franciscovich out on Wednesday and Thursday this week with a sore throat. Worsley may get the call.
Here we are out of the timeout. Von Tilburg slices that hard angle and gets the point out of the break. For the Rainbow Warriors, they were hitting 200 prior to that kick.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, one player who has stepped it up for the Cardinal is Eric Beatty. Normally he hits 230 on the earth, a couple kills per set. He's got three kills already, no errors, hitting 750. And Von Tilburg there gets up to zero, two kills, two errors.
Stanford hitting 500 for the set so far. And the dump shot works. There by Paul Bischoff, 6'5 freshman. In fact, Stanford has a setter situation similar to that of the Rainbow Warriors, where they have one option, a taller, more dynamic athlete at the net who brings about that kind of threat in Paul Bischoff. Kyle D'Agostino is a junior. He's 5'9".
Very similar setting situation for each team.
Von Tilburg that time straight down the line. But we will likely see Kyle D'Agostino at some point. And just like Joe Worsley, the shorter option at setter for Charlie Wade, he's kind of a feisty one.
Yeah, exactly. We will see, for sure, Joe Worsley at some point.
14 serving 16. Oh, back row set. One hand diving save by Tuileta. Face sets up Rosenmeier. High hands and out. And the crowd erupts as Hawaii cuts the deficit to one.
Well, Hawaii, the beneficiary of that cable contact there, slowed the ball down just enough for Tuileta to put up a one-arm dig. With the 15-point mark, Stanford hitting 500, Hawaii hitting 200. Hawaii with five hitting errors. Stanford only two. Let's check out Tuileta's dig there. The cable slows the ball down. Tuileta has just enough time to give up his body and put up the left-handed, one-handed dig. Allowed Hawaii to stay in that rally and get the point.
Tui Tuileta, seventh in the nation in digs per set. He has reached double figures seven times this year. Gassman anticipating the dump shot, but it was still too late. It was a beautiful pass by the libero, Evan Enriquez, and then Bischoff knew what to do with it.
Bischoff, Volleyball Magazine's High School National Player of the Year last year because of plays like that. That's pretty savvy right there. doing it twice in the last three plays. That's extraordinary.
His high school team, Glenbard West, went 42-0 in 2016 without losing a set. That one is hit into the net. The aforementioned Kyle D'Agostino.
84-0 in sets.
Yeah.
How about that? So D'Agostino is going to stay in.
So Rosie will serve. 16 serving 17. Tight one here in the opening set. Backside. It's Vega. One-handed in the air by Stein, and a great second touch effort there by two. Chance for the Cardinal, though. Middle set mistimed. Advantage now Hawaii. Jennings, backside to Stein. Off the block. And down for Hawaii point.
He was pop up again by two lefties. Always around. And then Van Tilburg finishing, screaming and hollering before the ball even goes down. He loves to celebrate, doesn't he?
We're tied for the fifth time in this first set. Bump set outside, the swing by Beatty off the block. Another chance here for Hawaii. They go to Gassman in the middle. Net violation against the Cardinal, and Hawaii reclaims the lead, 18-17. And John Costi signals for a timeout. A surge from the Rainbow Warriors, 5-1, puts them up one. Tight score on the scoreboard tonight. Series record also pretty tight. Sponsored by Aspen Hotels and Resorts, Hawaii leading the all-time series record by one match. The last meeting, February 13, 2016, they lost in four to Stanford in California. In fact, the home team has swept the series in each of the past three seasons. Hawaii fighting from behind here in this first set. They are up one. Vega out of the timeout. And that one goes nearly out of the arena.
Bench having some fun with that one. That was your basic. Did you call that a touch a mall shot? I don't know. You tell me.
That was Ruthian.
This Gabe had a good smile on his face afterwards. She knows it was a
James Anastasiadis.
Anastasiadis having fun with it.
And an ace by Brett Rosenmeier, and all of a sudden Hawaii leads by three. What a burst here in the late portion of set number one. Another timeout by the Cardinal. 5-0 Rainbow Run.
Big Island Candies, the perfect place to find the perfect gift. Visit them at their flagship store in Hilo, at Ala Moana Center, or online at bigislandcandies.com to see their amazing selection, including delicious chocolate dipped shortbreads.
Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. Hawaii on a 5-0 run. Yes, Hawaii 5-0 to take a three-point lead. Rosenmeier almost able to extend it. Missed the court, though, by a matter of inches. What do you think about the fight Stanford's putting up here in this opening set, Chris?
Impressive, especially given the fact that their star player, Jordan Ewert, is not here. It'd be a little bit like SC not having Yoder.
Which was the case, of course, last time out for Hawaii against the Trojans. Little pinball action on the Stanford side. It's returned. Jennings outside to Fay. The block was late, but still effective. Hawaii tries it again. Fay off the block and out this time. And Kupono doing something fierce here in this opening set. That's his fourth kill.
You know, I'm surprised that he's got as many kills as he does, because Stanford's trying to pick on. He's had to pass over half the receptions tonight. Tough to be a great passer and a great hitter all at once, and he's getting that job done tonight.
21 serving 18. Backside set. It's pounded by Beatty, but popped up by Worsley. Stein from the back row. And we play on. Enriquez wipes the palms of his hands on his jersey before setting the nectar to Clay Jones. That was something else.
You know what a transition Enriquez has made to college volleyball. He didn't play libero in high school ever. He was a hitter on the outside. And, you know, one time he hit like 96 swings in the state tournament. He's going to wipe his hands right there, make sure it doesn't go through his hands. Knew the ball would be wet. Perfect side set. Right in the money.
All MPSF second teamer last year, and the winner of the first ever Eric Shoji Award by Off the Block given to the top libero. It was the first year that it had adopted the Eric Shoji name. Of course, Eric, arguably the greatest libero of all time, who played at Stanford out of Punahou.
Exactly, and Evan also made first team All-American as well. Quite a year for him last year.
Oh, Jennings goes long on the serve, so Stanford still within striking distance, as they say.
Rolling this race to 25. Stanford used up both their timeouts. Charlie Wade has yet to use a timeout, so he has a little bit of control over the momentum right now.
Eric Beatty, one ace on the season. Rosenmeyer, perfect pass. And on the pipe, Rosenmeyer with a blasty blast.
That was perfectly executed. Great pass up front. Jennings Franciscovic catches both blockers a little off guard. Rakestraw not in position to block that Bick, that back real quick.
The book on Rosenmeyer is maybe he's not quite as explosive as some other outside hitters, and that's probably generally the case. Wasn't the case on that sequence, though.
Powerful. Dynamic.
Middle set, great dig there by Tui on the Rakestraw swing. Stein tried to get the touch, did he? No touch, according to the officials. And it's a point for Stanford. Luis Ventura, by the way, on top of the ladder tonight. Dixon Chun down on the floor. Kevin Chun and Bert Kasem, the two line judges. Stein off the block and out. And Hawaii has a low ball here in this competitive opening set.
I understand that Stein's parents are watching again tonight at 5 o'clock in the morning in the Netherlands.
Oh, out serve from Hendrik Mol, the birthday boy. A little juiced up maybe tonight, huh?
Yeah. How much icing on the cake?
The sugar rush.
The sugar rush.
So K-Rake to serve, tickles the tape, the pass by Faye. Franciscovic, backside, Von Tilburg, a laser beam to end things in the first. Kill number six for Stein Von Tilburg. Hawaii takes set one, 25-22. They'll swap sides and
Rainbow
do it again.
Warrior Volleyball on OC Sports is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, Kaiser Permanente, and Island Air.
Stein Von Tilburg, one of the top hitters in all the land, coming through with six put downs in that first set. Also got in on some of the roofing action in that opening stanza, Chris.
Six kills, three errors, and 12 tries. He was hitting negative to start the night, but he finishes strongly at the end of that first set. Capone Fay, they're picking on him as a passer. He's been passing money and hitting even better. Capone Fay, four kills, one error, and six tries, hitting 500 right now. Big night for Capone.
Brett Rosenmeyer with four kills of his own, hitting 250. Top hitter for Stanford in that first set. Eric Beatty had three kills in his first four swings. Actually ended that set, though, with three kills on six attacks. Still no errors, hitting 500, but Hawaii able to temper him a little bit down the stretch of that opening set. Some gaudy percentages. Stanford hitting 381. Hawaii ends up hitting 364 in that first set.
If John Costa were to be told, hey, we're going to hit 381 in the first set, he's saying, hey, we're going to win. But not against the Hawaii team that has this great crowd and the Hawaii team that hits 364.
And a Hawaii team that, frankly, hasn't faced a ton of adversity over the course of this win streak. That set, though, represented a little bit of that. They were down past the midsection portion.
For the last five home matches, definitely the most resistance, for sure.
Stein dug up back over the net. Outside, it's Faye. Lines up, uncoils right there to dig it up is Clay Jones. Backside goes to Beatty. The roll shot works.
Beatty's got the on hand now. Picks up kill number four. No errors.
Beatty bringing the offensive goods and also bringing the emotion. About as pumped up as anybody out there on the floor.
Just a freshman.
Jennings outside to Faye. Diving save by Enriquez. Back row set. Jones is dug up by Stein. Here's Faye again. Through the block. Somehow return. Hawaii almost caught napping. Here's Faye. The touch shot right there is Vega. Another swing for Beatty. Blocked back and roof by Hendrick Mole.
Birthday boy. Very disciplined in staying home and touched it down. We'll see if there's a double contact up here by Stanford. There's one touch. There's another touch. Same guy hit it twice. There you go.
So all's well that ends well for Charlie Wade and his crew.
Athletic justice.
There you go.
As your father would say.
This one coming towards us. And look out along press row. It's a service ace for Hawaii. And all is well here along media lane.
Well, we didn't get nailed in the head like poor Ryan Kalei Tsuji during the 6:30 warm-up show. Game on.
That was square. Middle set blocked and rolled. Hendrick Mole returned to sender.
Hendrick Mole's got his fourth block tonight already.
That would be the case. Three serving one. Hawaii off to a fast start, just like in the opening set. Vega, nicely done there, hitting from the opposite position. Vega, who moved back over to the outside hitter spot this year, but wasn't able to really get a good run up into the season, was injured in the fall, so head coach John Costley saying he's just now hitting his stride.
And boys, he got some hops. He played some great basketball at Iolani and volleyball. He got the Stanford, it's been just volleyball. He's got the great jump serve as well.
And he deals the ace right there.
11 service aces on the year. He's the fourth leading acer on the team. Nice top spin, just dives at the last minute.
6'7", fifth year senior. And just missed another ace down the line wide. So Hawaii Bucks back up 4-3.
Electrical engineering major. Played some volleyball at Kuikahi for Tony Obrey, one of the great youth volleyball coaches that also coaches at HBA.
Here it comes from Faye. Pass by Jones. He'll get the set on the outside, and the block had not formed for Hawaii. Clay Jones stepping up his game in the absence of Jordan Ewert. All-around physical style player. Because he is an upperclassman, Coach John Costi says he just is able to bring a certain steadiness to the fray, a team that is loaded with youngers. Rosenmeier. He's really bringing the pop tonight.
Well, his arm looks live tonight. At the end of last week, I thought his arm looked getting a little tired, looked like. Tonight, that's anything but tired. That's a live arm.
Five kills for Rosie. He's hitting 333, and Hendrick Mole to send it across into the net. Service error number 6 for Hawaii compared to 4 for the Cardinal. We're tied at 5.
Mole's got 2 of those 6 errors.
Stanford coming off of 2 straight wins. They actually did an East Coast swing. Oh boy, Kupono Faye. That was some sheer power. And it went upstairs on Evan Enriquez.
One Hawaiian to another right there. Big back real quick by Kupono Faye.
Pass by Vega. Outside, it's Jones off the block, kept alive there by Faye. Jennings missed the court. There was some open Terraflex. He wasn't able to take advantage.
Oh, he had the shot. It was pretty wide open. Jennings is getting those good passes tonight, right up tight to the net. And he can become very offensive when he's in the front row.
I mentioned Stanford taking the East Coast swing last week. Beat Lees McCray out of Conference Carolinas. As Rosenmeier gets stuffed by Paul Bischoff. Again, the taller option at setter, Bischoff, providing that bigger block on the right side.
A very physical block here by Bischoff. Turns that ball back into the court. He played 2 years of football in high school.
as well.
Alas, service error ties things up again. Cardinal then followed up the win against Lees McRae with a sweep of Penn State. And John Costi saying that they felt pretty good about themselves here making this trip to Hawaii, but obviously the Rainbow Warriors feeling about as positive as they can feel with this recent run. Backside, here's Beatty, two-handed in the air by Tuileta. Stein with the swing off the block, and now he is so good at tooling that block. And Hawaii jumps up.
Pretty uncanny the way Stein manages to tool the block, even when he's hit from the back row. Finds a way to do it.
Tied for second in the nation in kills per set, 10th nationally in hitting percentage. Another serve into the net for Hawaii. They're starting to pile up.
Seven on the night so far.
Great stroke. And there's Jennings this time, center of the floor.
You know, I think he's going to continue to be offensive until Stanford starts going up with him, you know, assigning a blocker to commit to him. Right now, they're not going up with him, so he's saying, I'll just have a field day here and hit it to the open part of the court.
You got two setters, one on each side, deft at that kind of play, as Pat Gasman deals an ace out of the deck.
They're picking on the new person in the lineup, Clay Jones. Even though he's a senior, he's been around a few times. Only 11 sets in 2016.
Sixth service ace of the season for Pat Gasman. Third tonight for Hawaii. Forces the overpass. Hendrick Mole can't put it down. Enriquez, the pickup. Beatty off the block. Right there is Gasman. Now Stein. Oh, Enriquez is there again. That was pretty. Beatty by the double block. Save. Here's Fay on the swing, sends it long, and the Cardinals survive a marathon sequence.
Oh, some pretty good volleyball there. Fans loving and yelling. Even when Hawaii loses a rally, these fans will clap for great volleyball.
Evan Enriquez, a couple of stellar pop-ups. Middle set, that's Mole. He is getting some tremendous lift here as of late.
Julia looks fresh. Looks like cuts this ball back. Cut back shot across his body. They're taking the wrist away from him.
Siskovich with the serve. Hawaii up by two. Backside, here's Vega. Off the block, diving save Rosenmeyer. Jennings plays it off the net. Free ball coming here for the Cardinals. Quick middle set, that's Moy. Here's Rosenmeyer. Little chin music for Bischoff. Great second touch there by Enriquez, and we play on. Franciscovic, backside, Stein.
Oh my goodness, if you leave Stein by Tilburg with a skip block or a one blocker, it's sayonara. Well, watch this. This is unbelievable. Here's a great dig by Bischoff. He's their leading digger tonight, by the way. Van Tilburg finishes it. And with the Van Tilburg signature celebration.
Outside, that's Beatty. Sends it wide. No touch up front. And Hawaii has opened up a four-point advantage after a 3-0 run. And a timeout taken by John Costi on the front side of the media timeout at 15. Time now for the Fujitsu air conditioning cool play of the game. It came moments ago. Stein von Tilburg finishing that last point. Check this thing out now in real time. See if you can feel the heat coming right at you. SVT, indeed.
He's got it going again. Started out hitting negative on the night over the first half dozen points. He was one kill, two errors. And he's more than made up for now with his eight kills, three errors.
Back row set. How in the world did Clay Jones get that one down? Looked like he sort of stumbled on the jump, didn't get a lot of lift, still made it work.
Well, it helps when you're 6'7". Yeah, that was definitely a scramble to get to the ball.
How about the set by Jennings? Franciscovich off the net is able to bump set it right into the wheelhouse of Stein von Tuber.
I wish we had another cool play for that, because that would be it for me. That bump set off the net was so difficult.
Is there a Fujitsu cooler play of the game?
You got to get low, and you got to pop it up, and then you got to sit down and watch it. So you sat down and watched it. Got a nice little spectator seat. That was cool. Or cooler.
We'll see if it's the coolest by the end of the night. Kupono Fay to serve. Back row set. Here's Vega. Smoke streaming off of that. And the Cardinal getting the point back.
Tell you what, Gabo Vega gets the ball where he wants and the right timing and everything else. His hops are so amazing. He gets up so high. He can hit over any block around. When he gets hot, he is the toughest player on their team.
Stephen Molina with the serve. The floater handled by Rosenmeier. Middle set, Hendrik Mol. He was up among the clouds. Hawaii hits 15 first. Hendrik Mol, excuse him while he kisses the sky. Hawaii up 4. Welcome back. The Jack Fact tonight is consistency in the polls and pollsters. Top four teams in the ABCA poll have not changed in 4 weeks. You got number one, Ohio State, number two, Long Beach State, BYU third, Hawaii fourth. In this week's poll, 23 of the 24 coaches' ballots have the same top four teams in that precise order.
That's pretty rare. That's a lot of agreement.
And I think the one coach who had a different ballot basically just had BYU and Hawaii flip-flop. Rakestraw out of the timeout, able to get the side and point for Stanford.
You know, it's interesting. Hawaii plays BYU next week at Provo. And I noticed tonight in the box score for the BYU Pepperdine game, Ben Pasch, arguably the best player in the country, and the most dynamic at least, did not play.
Here's Rosenmeier. One hand save. Enriquez in the press row. They come again, and it plays on. Rosenmeier, the tip shot. Missed wide. Point Cardinal. And that was all Stanford effort right there.
Wow, that's some kind of effort. Oh, how many players are coming over at us. Now, there's at least two players crashing. There's Beatty and Bischoff. In the end of the play, Rosenmeier sees some open space, but gets it just wide.
Eric Beatty's having a good old time tonight.
He is, isn't he?
He enjoys playing this game.
He does, he does.
And he's back to serve. Middle set, that's Gassman, one hand save, Enriquez. He has been doing that all night. Rosenmeier, deep corner and long. No, it will be called in by the top official, Luis Ventura. Line judge had the out signal. Ventura says he saw it. Hawaii gets the point.
I'll tell you what happened. The line judge actually was trying to avoid the ball, and I'm not sure he saw the ball land. He looked down after the ball had already hit, and just I think he made a guess. Luis Ventura, though, great call. He was watching the ball the whole way. I like when the top officials follow the ball like that. Just call it as they see it.
16 serving 13. Middle set not there. Hawaii now with a chance. Here's Rosenmeier. The roll shot, diving save. Beatty Gassman finishes the deal.
Stanford with one timeout left. I'm not sure they can let Hawaii get too separated from them right now. 17-13, maybe one more point. They can, John Kosha can allow, but not much more than that.
Stein von Kilberg, as the sign says, with the serve. Beatty down the line and wide. So Hawaii another point, and yeah, John Costi can't wait any longer. He signals for a timeout. Largest lead of this second stanza for the home team, Rainbow Warriors.
As long as you look at Costi, you got to tell your Costi story about Yuval Kotz. The story he was talking, it was amazing.
He basically, in talking about how comfortable he was with this place and this road trip, of course, having created a bit of a pipeline from Hawaii to that Stanford volleyball program, he said, you know, it goes all the way back to the days when we were game planning for a guy named Yuval Katz, as he said.
That's right.
Of course, talking about Yuval Katz, and he said it was just about impossible. The fan, or in other words, the range by which Yuval Katz could find the floor and could hit certain angles from that opposite position. He said it was just about impossible to game plan for. And then he said, oh, and then, of course, we're playing in front of 10,282 people. Let's go to Ryan Kalesuji. Ryan.
Hey, thanks, Kano. Well, a lot of emotion on the Hawaii sideline. One of the themes that the Hawaii coaches keep reiterating to their team is all about defense, really trying to inspire them to play great defense. Jenny Franciscovich also having a fantastic match. He's really taken on the leadership mantle and really the motivator during the timeouts as well as on the court. Back to you guys.
I would agree with that assessment, Chris. I think part of the reason, certainly, that this Hawaii team has been able to put together this 18-2 record and all of these straight wins and all of these straight sweeps. Yeah, Stein von Tilburg has been a beast. Kupono Fei and Brett Rosenmeier, all of those guys have elevated their game. But Jennings Franciscovich has really been the essence of what has driven this team.
You know, he was sick two of the three practices this week. There's some questions whether he played a lot tonight. He's playing just like he always does.
Rosenmeier with the joust. Will be a swing here for Jones, and he's able to trickle it down off the block.
Good scramble play by Stanford that time. They're out of sorts for almost that whole play. And somehow or another, Jones pulled what rabbit out of the hat.
And he will retreat back to serve. Coming off of that win against Penn State, he had 12 kills, hit a career high 556. Stein von Tilburg, that is his 10th kill of the evening. So double figures again for Stein von Tilburg for the 15th time in 20 matches this year.
Amazing. Another great story on Clay Jones. He just finished serving, but last year at Stanford, when Stanford, you know, won both nights, Clay Jones went in, hit, they were down by 9 points. He served 8 in a row. So this is a dangerous team.
On Tilburg. He's been the most dangerous guy on the floor, though, tonight offensively. 11 kills. That one puts him over 400. He's batting 421.
And I do like his new nickname, Van Kilburg. You like that?
I love it.
SVT, Van Kilburg.
Hawaii up a half dozen. Middle set. And Rakestraw able to find the floor. A couple of the Rainbow Warriors thought maybe that was wide, but no challenge from Charlie Wade. We got a softball score for you. How about another win for the Rainbow Wahine? 8-1 over Toledo. And from Les Murakami Stadium, Hawaii up 2-1 on Sacred Heart in the bottom of the fifth. Meanwhile, here in the SSC, Pat Gassman and company keep rolling.
Two middles are trading blows. Rakestraw first, then Gassman next. Battle of the middles.
Six players for the Bows with at least 2 kills so far in this match. Backside, Beatty down the line and in. Now the players may be urging Charlie Wade to take a look. And he will go for the ping pong paddle. And he will challenge the call, the in-out call, and Dixon Chun will put on the headset and he'll take a look. That one was urged on by the players.
Which is usually the best time to challenge. I don't think a coach should ever get involved in doing the challenge without consulting his players.
Charlie getting some feedback from the fans along the baseline. A lot of officials around the area at a time like this. Let's take a look here. Oh, that looked like it was smack dab on the line. Again, 3 challenges for each coach throughout the match. There's no reward for winning the challenge.
It's let's watch this one again. I think this gets an awful lot of green. Yeah, it looks like a lot of green.
Maybe
there's some white too. Yeah. I don't think there's enough evidence there to overturn the in call.
Survey says in. So a point for Stanford. Charlie will have two challenges left. John Costi yet to use one on the Stanford side. Kyle D'Agostino again enters into the match late in a set.
13 service aces on the year, number two on the team after Ewart, who's not here. So in essence, he's the number one acer on the team on this trip.
Two-hand pass there by Tui, and there's James again.
You can't put a price tag on that part of Hawaii's offense to have Tui Tui left to take a jump serve with his hands and pass it super accurately for Jennings Franciscovich. Franciscovich becomes an attacker. No block up at all. Nowhere to be found.
And it will be Franciscovich to serve, and it's a good one. D'Agostino tracks down the set. And now a chance here for Hawaii. One hand set to Mole, dug up by Enriquez. Beatty the swing. Off the block and out. How many points has Evan Enriquez saved for Stanford tonight?
Many. Many, many. I think in high school we just knew him as a hitter. What a hitter he was. I think one time he took 96 swings or something in like a state final playing for Kamehameha Hawaii.
Esteemed volleyball family over there on the Big Island. Stein with the swing, two-hand in the air by D'Agostino. Beatty against a triple block. Here's Stein again. And even the great Evan Enriquez wasn't able to pop that one up. A hard angle cross court by the Flying Dutchman.
Stein showing that he's got the wide fan as well. He can bring it down the line. He's got that sharp cross court hit as well, almost inside the 3-meter line.
23 serving 17. Hawaii in control here in the second set. Faye, that one tickled the top of the tape. Backside set, Beatty into the pin. Point Hawaii, it's Aloha ball for the Bows in set two.
What a pass by Enriquez. That was a tough serve to handle. He popped up there where D'Agostino could put up a set to any one of three different attackers.
Hawaii has won now 27 straight sets. Looking to add to that number. Outside the swing by Jones, and Hawaii will get a chance here. Pipe set goes to Faye, he knuckles it over, diving save, pancake style by Enriquez, and then Jones gets denied by Stein and Hendrick Mole. A stop to end set two. Hawaii has now won 28 straight sets, and at intermission, they'll have a chance to crack open the broom closet at the SSC.
Rainbow Warrior Volleyball on OC Sports is sponsored by Strong and Hawaii Honda Dealers.
Well, here are the McDonald's match statistics. Hawaii up two sets to none, C-Mac.
Well, nothing usual there. Hawaii with a great kill percentage, 343. The Stanford's 250. The second set especially was significant, where Hawaii hit over 380 and held their only opponent to under 200. Blocks 5-3. That's Hawaii usually wins that block party. They're doing it again tonight.
Subplot, side story that's presented itself tonight. Those two set wins gives Hawaii now 28 straight set victories. The program record set in 1996 when they went to the national championship game, 29. They can tie that tonight. That's at least a possibility.
Yeah. You know what, though? I talked to Charlie Wade about this earlier this week. He said he's not concerned about that in the least. He's just not interested in the results. He just wants to all about the process. Let's just take care of one day at a time, one set at a time. We'll worry about the records later.
And he says the players have done, to their credit, a great job in being locked in and focused. Just like Tui Tui Leta, yeah, who will be our focus for the Central Pacific Bank. how it works. Chris, tell us about this two-hand pass.
Well, what, Tui left? This is so hard to do. When somebody gets a jump serve, usually you use your forearms to pass. Tui uses his hands where he can control them all much better. He puts it right where Jennings Franciscovich can be an attacker at the net. This is a difficult skill. Not many people can do that. What Tui does, he has such strong hands. And then he's just got the fist pump. He's the quarterback. You know, he was a great quarterback, by the way. You remember him as a quarterback, don't you, Cano?
Oh, yeah.
He was pretty amazing. Now he's quarterbacking this volleyball team. When Tui speaks, the players listen.
A state champion quarterback. And he is just a jack of all trades and has found a role that he's excelled at here for this Rainbow Warrior team. A 21-year-old sophomore as it currently stands. And that's an out ball. And a point for Hawaii, and we may have a challenge this time from John Costi. Gabo Vega is actually urging his head coach to take another look at that.
Yes.
Well, at least Costi didn't hold up the Outrigger Resort's side of the paddle and ask for a free night at the Outrigger. like Nygaard did last week from USC.
Outrigger getting some... That campaign has really had some legs. It had some lasting power.
You know, they've been a huge supporter of both men's and women's volleyball throughout the years. They've got decades-long support of Hawaii sports, so they deserve a few extra calls here and there. Dixon Chun once again checking on the monitor.
So let's take a look at this here. Gabo Vega going down the line. It was called out. Oh, but that one...
Oh, that looks pretty good.
Way in.
That's way in.
Yeah, that was a quick peek there from Dixon Chun. So, rightfully so.
Likely Dixon Chun made a quick call, but didn't ask for multiple views. Mm-hmm. He saw right away what the call was, and he made it. That was good.
When you know, you know. So, give the kill to Vega. Give the point to Stanford. And it's 1-0 here in set three. There's Tui with the pass. Outside, it's Von Tilburg, blocked and roofed. Rake straw. The seven-footer in the thick of things again. It was Paul Bischoff jumping up next to him.
In the rare times that Von Tilburg will get blocked, this time he does. Actually, Bischoff, I think, got most of that one. I think Von Tilburg was trying to avoid rake straw.
So some time being taken to wipe perspiration off of the Terraflex here across the way and also pick up some debris. You know, during intermission, they have all of those games, those promotional competitions, and I mean, there are people that are diving all over the place, running back and forth. You don't know what's going to end up collecting out there on the playing surface.
The last one was, I think it was much of, there was some cardboard, I think.
Yeah.
Some of the cardboard flakes fell off, maybe.
Yeah, they had to construct out of cardboard pieces,
right?
You know, various shapes and logos. And Charlie Wade saying, can we make this quick, please?
We got a match to play.
Like Jennings Franciscovich actually has come over to us now a couple of times and has given us small shards of cardboard. Hawaii entering this match third in the MPSF, and they have to this point separated themselves. We showed you the top four rankings and how those have been frozen for 4 weeks, but certainly Hawaii has joined that group atop the MPSF standings, Long Beach State and BYU, as sort of the hierarchy, the top three in the league to this point for sure. And this weekend, Hawaii can actually clinch a spot in the postseason. They have that opportunity.
Yeah, Rosemary, he's in there forever, like he's floating in a cloud. Luckily, he touched it before he hit the ground. Otherwise, we've been a violation.
Middle set, great dig there by Kupono Fei off of the swing by Jones. He'll get the swing against a triple block and find the baseline. And Hawaii ties things up here in the third.
The broken play, Kupono Fei goes over the block, catches the back line.
But his attacking is just magic tonight. This is his sixth kill, 14 tries.
82-86. Forces the overpass. Rosenmeier, what a layout by Mole to keep it alive off the ricochet. Rosenmeier again blocked. So Tui sets up Stein. By the double block and down. Are you serious?
Well, this is what the great teams do. They make the little plays, like cover your hitter. When a hitter attacks, you're going to assume that, hey, maybe they'll get blocked. So look at that. Henrik Mole pops up the first one. There's a set by Toileta. That gets blocked, and I believe he covered the next one. And then finally, Van Tilburg terminates as usual.
Beatty cross court, two-handed in the air by Franciskovic. So Faye sets up Stein over the 7-foot block. Now a swing by Vega. Gabriel Vega with his sixth put down of the match, hitting over 300.
We call him Gabo, and he gets up high. I don't know if this one goes over, or he just cuts down the line. Block is blocking him too far inside. Great shot by Gabo.
And like Tuileto, a multi-sport athlete at Iolani, he's a member of the 2010 State Basketball Championship team under head coach Dean Shimamoto. Hendrik Mole, on his birthday, continues the onslaught. That's kill number four. He's error-free to go along with a handful of denials at the net.
Patrick Gassman also with four kills. Lisa Strandmaa wanting more sets to go to those middles. That's a great middle talking, right?
Yeah, of course. Of course. Very predictable. Outside, here's Rosie. Winds up, uncoils. A diving save by Enriquez. What else is new? Vega, the touch shot. Smart decision that time by the senior.
Evan Enriquez, once again, he's got 10 kills now, I believe. He's the only digger in double figures. His father, Guy, will tell you that he's the one who taught him about the dive, but I think Julie, the mom, actually taught him about diving, playing defense like that. There's Guy. Oh, and there's Julie together. Guy used to coach at Oregon State. And Julie played there. She says a thumbs up. There's Shannon Cuehu, daughter-in-law.
In fact, Evan's middle name is Guy, so he carries his dad's namesake. There's Stein off the fingertips. Back row set, Vega. Oh, just missed the end line. Stanford wants a touch. No touch is called, and we may have another review challenge here by John Costi. You can't take him back on the plane with you. You only get three per night, so you might as well use them if you're John Costi.
And the worst case scenario is if your team isn't playing well or out of sorts at all, it works as a timeout.
Game's exactly.
Delayed, everybody's gonna stop, the server gets cool. The other team's attackers cool off a little bit.
Now, the key here is he has to pinpoint to the official what he's challenging. I believe he's challenging the touch, not the in-out call.
Right.
But challenging instead the touch at the net.
And I believe it was a touch. Right. I think it was by Faber's right hand.
Well, John Costi was reminiscing about some of the glory years in this building, sellouts with the likes of Yuval Kotz. The gang. The crowds haven't necessarily filled this arena, but they're busting out the wave right now during this review, Chris, and it's kind of a sight to behold here. Men's volleyball is back here in Manoa.
It very definitely is. They're a fun team to watch. Charlie Wade's been exhorting the fans after every match, thanking the fans for coming and telling all those people at home, hey, you want to come down and watch something good? Check this team out. They're fun.
And after tonight, there are only going to be three more regular season opportunities to see this team in person in this building. Of course, we'll find out about their postseason fate as the season plays on. They have an opportunity this weekend to actually punch a ticket to the MPSF playoffs, which is a remarkable thing. But again, the clock is ticking, and this is a team that I think has the makings of being something really special.
No question. Charlie Wade. You know, will not be satisfied with just punching a ticket and being in the top eight. He wants to be top four so he can host the first round of the MPSF playoffs and treat these fans to something even more special.
Well, as you were able to probably decipher, the call on the review challenge went the way of Stanford a touch, but Stein Van Tilburg righting the ship immediately.
13 kills for Stein. He did 360. Another big night for Stein.
Back row set, Vega. Oh, he is starting to feel it. And a lot of the damage done on that pipe set.
And most local players that come back and play in the Stan Schaff Center, female or male, doesn't make any difference, tend to have big nights playing in front of hometown fans.
The list goes on and on. You're right. Jennings, middle set. Gassman is roofed. Solo style by Stephen Moy.
Stephen Moy, who's been a little quiet tonight, I guess the big block. Moy at 6'9 going up against the 6'10 Gassman. Nice matchup there, size-wise.
Outside, Rosenmeier off the block, and now in violation against Stanford. Either way you slice it, it's a point for the Rainbow Warriors. Again, Hawaii has won 28 straight sets. The program record is 29. Last week, we were given a bit of an inaccurate piece of information. Originally, it was thought that the record from 96 was 35 straight sets won, but in actuality, it's 29. So an opportunity, certainly, for this team to do something that will be of note and worthy of conversation. But as you alluded to, Chris, during the break, that's not at all at the forefront of thought for Charlie Wade again.
I think if you recall, which you probably won't, but I think if you recall, way back when at the beginning of the streak, I said, it's so hard to beat another Division I team three in a row. You know, it's more likely than not that teams go 3-1 or 3-2, but to go 3-0 is really difficult. What they've done is nothing short of amazing.
Faye through the block. Oh, great save there by Bischoff. Free ball coming, though, here for Hawaii. Tui the first touch. Jennings, second touch, dump shot. Diving save by Jones, and the swing by Vega. Dug up back over the net, and then put down by Beatty. And this is the largest lead of this third set here for Stanford.
Credit to Card for playing some scrappy defense. James Franciscovich would like to have that dump shot back. He dumped it way too deep into the court. He's got to dump that one more straight down, more vertical and less horizontal.
Stanford has, you can say, won probably the majority of those longer scramble rallies. They lead by three here in the third.
27 digs to Hawaii's 22.
We got a net violation against the Cardinal. It would have been an out ball by Stein. But Hawaii gets the much needed point. They're back to within two. 14 kills for Stein von Tilburg. Hitting 385 prior to that swing. Gassman into the net. So again, a modicum of adversity here presenting itself for this Rainbow Warrior team, playing from behind here in this third set.
I'm Charlie Wade. I'm going, you know, this is really good for us. We need some adversity. We need to play games that really matter when we really got to scramble.
Faye.
Oh, Faye, seven kills, 17 tries, hitting over 270 probably. Finds the hole in the block.
Punahou alum has taken his game to another level the last 3 or 4 weeks. Franciscovich, a good serve. And nobody gets the third touch. Stanford standing around, and Hawaii back within a point.
That's a rarity. Everybody's got an assignment there except the guy who's going to go get it over.
Franciscovich with the serve. Backside, it goes to Beatty off the block and down. Middle set, Mole. Oh man, he's taking that elevator all the way to the top floor.
He really is. Celebrating his birthday a little bit early, wouldn't you say? He loves getting more sets in the middle. And I think Jennings Francisco is doing a nice job of picking the right time to set to Gassman and go to Mola. They're rarely having two blockers up at all.
Middle set, dug up by Faye. Franciscovic sets up Rosie. Oh, that one actually ricocheted off the top of the net. Found its way out of bounds.
Got you on the recoil.
Yeah, the quicker Hawaii can wrap things up, the quicker Hendrik Mol can enjoy his birthday cake.
Yeah. Rosie's fifth hitting error. You better be careful. He's got about half of Hawaii's hitting errors so far. He might give way to Austin Matautia. As I said earlier, one of the keys to the game is be ready, Hawaii bench. Jenny Franciscovich is sick 2 days this week. Maybe Joe Wurz will get called upon. Maybe Rosenmeier, you know, who's struggling right now, will need a break. Matautia might spell him.
11 serving 12. The roll shot served by Mole. Beatty blasts it long. Was there a touch? No touch. Point Hawaii, and they have fought their way back into a tie. They're knotted up for the fifth time here in the third. Hendrik Mole, 5 kills on 8 swings, no errors, 5 blocks. And an out serve.
That was rare. He tried 2 roll serves in a row. That's unusual. I think he was probably doing that because he had already missed 2 serves previously, so he wanted to make sure he got both of his serves in.
So much for that.
He went 1 for 2.
Outside, Rosenmeier dug up by Rakestra. The swing by Jones, able to plug it through that block. And Stanford jumps up too. You got to give this Cardinal team some credit. Playing shorthanded without their top hitter, Jordan Ewert, against a red-hot Rainbow Warrior team. Not giving up here in the third, even though they trail 2 sets to 9. Stein von Tilburg not giving up on his onslaught either. That's kill number 16.
This is as tough as any team has played Hawaii during the streak, wouldn't you say?
Agreed.
Here we go now. Come on, Jenny.
Toe-to-toe, they're beating him to 15 in one set.
This in many ways sort of represents the crossroads, if you will, or the graduation of Hawaii against higher level competition. Next week at Provo against BYU. But if this guy, SVT, keeps playing the way he's playing, Hawaii's going to be a hard out for anybody in the country.
Whenever we interview the opposing coaches, we say, well, what do you think about Hawaii? They go, oh, yeah, they're pretty good, but that Ben Silver, he's really good. He's having a special year.
Jones off the block and out. Stanford first to 15. Hawaii trailing by a point here in the third. Welcome back. Let's check out the First Hawaiian Bank top three. MPSF dig leaders, Larry Tuituileta for Hawaii. 7th nationally and 2nd in the MPSF at 2.46 digs per set. Andrew Sato for Long Beach State is number 1 on the list. Andrew Sato, who happens to be the reigning MPSF Player of the Week, which is a rarity for a libero.
Yeah, it really is.
Gassman out of the timeout. Got a touch. And Hawaii gets the point. They even things up out of that break.
Hawaii hit 318 at the break. Stanford hitting 562 in this third set. No wonder they're all knotted up here.
Here's Brett Rosenmeier. That's the serve in. Cardinal go middle set. Diving one hand save Stein. But the 2 Punahou alums unable to track down that 2nd touch. You see from Les Murakami Stadium, Hawaii up 3-1 on Sacred Heart. Good to see Mike Trapasso and that group playing well. They found their bats on the mainland in the tournament up in Minneapolis a couple weeks ago. Good punch shot there from Stein von Tilburg.
The one that makes Stein so good is that on bad sets like this, Jennings is the first to know this was too low, too tight, and von Tilburg finds a way. Very resourceful in how he tools the block with wipe-off shots like that.
Yeah, that is artistry in action right there. 16 serving 16. Joe Worsley in with the serve. Vega 2 hands it over. Chance here for Hawaii. Jennings sets up Bay, blocked and roofed. Eric Beatty saying, oh, no, you don't.
I think Capone made the right shot. He was trying to go down the line, but Beatty would have none up, and he was all the way over to the antenna. And yes, celebrate almost like SVT.
I think Eric Beatty was pretty pleased with the result of that play, I would say.
It's a great block. Coming off that great career of Huntington Beach High School, and the two times national high school champions. He was a first team high school American in 2016. This recruiting class, John Costi and Ken Chibuya,
yeah,
and Daniel Lasai put together number one in the country.
There's Mole. Slam dunks it down to the floor. Andrew Mole now with six kills, still error free. Stanford, by the way, six total team blocks, three of them in this third set. Hawaii with five blocks for the match, zero here in set three. Franciscovich with a good serve. Outside it goes to Vega against a double block. Works it to his benefit. And that's now double-digit kills for Gabo Vega. He's got 10 kills on 17 swings.
More importantly, he's hitting for just an amazing percentage. 471. Most outside hitters are hitting around, you get 280, 290 out of them, you're doing well.
Well, he hits 238 for the season, and then they follow it up with an ace by Eric Beatty. And Charlie Wade signals for a timeout. So Hawaii approaching the home stretch of set three. Streak on the line for what it's worth. Welcome back. For the latest information on UH Athletics, go to hawaiiathletics.com. For UH news, tickets, videos, and more, also visit UH's Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube sites to follow your favorite teams and get current fan promotions. Well, Hawaii being pushed about as hard as they've been throughout this win streak. In this third set, Von Tilburg out of the timeout, restoring a sense of order with his 18th kill. Hawaii has won 28 straight sets. The program record, 29 from 96. Now, the number 35 had been thrown out last week. They did win 35 straight sets, but two matches were exhibitions, so they don't count towards the official record. Kupono Fei serves it into the net. That's service error number 10. That's been a bit of a bugaboo here tonight for Hawaii. And a lot of them have been very ill-timed.
I would say that would be one of them.
Yeah. Stanford first to 20. Vega sends it long. So he responds with an out serve of his own. Hawaii back within a point. For a match where Hawaii's up two sets to none, we got a little bit of drama on the line here.
This is great stuff. The Moles missed three serves tonight, so I believe that's why Anastasiadis is going to take his place in the server's box.
Has a younger brother, Alex, 6'7 opposite, who's a Long Beach State commit. Perfect pass by Enriquez. Outside. Jones is dug up by Faye. Here's Rosenmeier off the block. Faye going to Stein. That was an opposing block of 7 feet and 6'7". And for Von Tilburg, it didn't matter.
He just doesn't seem to care. He's fearless. He was fearless. He OTT there, I think.
A little bit of OTT action over the top. And a timeout by Stanford. 19 kills for Stein Von Tilburg, hitting 484. And Hawaii has worked it back to a tie, leading two sets to none. And it's knotted at 20 apiece. Stein Von Tilburg, where do you start in describing his night, C-Mac?
Well, I'll tell you, he's had a couple of great digs. He's been blocking well at the net, hitting well out of the back row, out of the front row. Hits well out of front left. He's got 18 kills so far. One thing Hawaii's got to be careful of is setting him too much, especially as we enter into the last one-third of the season. You know, you want to be getting stronger then. You don't want to be getting, you know, tired arms and tired legs that one-third when you got the MPSF tournament coming up and you got the NCAA championships coming up. So it's really important to make sure that a guy like Stein doesn't get completely relied on too much.
That has happened in the past for these Charlie Wade coached teams, and really going back even prior to his tenure,
where Hawaii has a great example.
Great example. 2 years ago, Hawaii put together an incredible regular season run, winning a bunch of matches in a row, but yeah, kind of gassing out down the stretch of the season. Let's check in with Ryan Kalesuji.
Thanks, Kanoa. Well, Coach Costi talked to his team, especially his blockers, about their hand positioning. He also said, in this final stretch, track number four, of course, number four, Stein von Tilburg, saying we have to make sure to track him, regardless of if he's in the front row or the back row. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. There you see Associate Head Coach Ken Shibuya next to John Costi. He hails from Virginia. And a little tie to the Hawaii coaching staff. Josh Walker said that that was the first volleyball camp he ever participated in, was put on by Ken Shibuya. And in fact, Ken Shibuya was a coach at his high school and was the guy responsible for starting the volleyball program at his high school. Had moved on to college prior to Josh Walker playing for that program. But he says, in many ways, Ken Shibuya is the reason I'm here, as you see Stanford winning the joust action at the net.
Josh Walker is unafraid to share his roots and his relationship with Ken Shibuya. There we see another local boy with roots in Daniel Asai. And there's Josh Walker, one of the all-time greats here at Hawaii. He played overseas and successful as a pro.
Stanford up one. Backside. Here's Stein through the block and down. He does it again. Give him 20 kills for the match.
They tracked it. And it still didn't make a difference. They got two blockers up on him, so Jennings and Francisco didn't fool anybody to get the ball to Stein. He had two blockers up there, well-formed block. Now Stein goes to the back row, or maybe he's even better.
21 serving 21. And it is Stein with the serve. Back row set, Vega. Oh, Faye had the first touch, went off of Tuileta and down. Gabo Vega going nuclear on that swing.
Boy, Gabo's really stepping it up. Seems like he's getting higher miles per hour as the match goes on.
It's 11 kills for Vega, 22 serving 21. Hawaii trailing again. Jennings outside, Rosenmeier. Net violation against Stanford. About the third time we've seen that in this set. And we're tied at 22.
The time Stephen Moy, the freshman from El Segundo, got hung up in the net. Both teams trying to be aggressive here. Pick up some stuff blocks for points.
Rosie with the long inhale. Go. Outside.
There's Gassman, he's gone. Faye by himself against the high solo block. Not the straight down variety, the one that's in the air for a long time and still counts as a block solo.
And Hawaii up one, timeout Stanford. Kupono Faye saying, ah, ole. All by himself.
Good job, boys. Good job, boys.
And check out the crowd here in the front row. They know it's in. And they make the proper signal. Oh, man, you got to love the volleyball crowd.
Notice they're not holding any beers.
Yeah.
Of course, remember?
That was last season, yeah.
Last season.
All I know is that pair of volleyball fans, they have tremendous tickets.
Their friends are telling them, hey, you're on TV right now. Yeah. Take a look.
They always have front row seats.
Yeah.
In some cases, we're not going to, you know, roll the bus over them too much here, but in some cases, they enjoy an adult beverage or two.
Yes. They love their volleyball. They had that call there. Correct. Yeah. That's for sure.
I mean, you got to love the volleyball crowds here at the Stan Sheriff Center. I mean, it is just something else. So intelligent, so knowledgeable of the game.
One more.
And they enjoy the purity of the play. If it's a long play, even if it goes as a point to the other team, they will applaud the effort. They enjoy the purity of the game.
You know, all the players will tell you this is one of the best places to play, if not the best place to play in the country, in regards to this fan knowledge. There's not a whole lot of trash talking or people saying nasty things about your mother or your girlfriend. You know, they just this volleyball, like you say, is a pure volleyball crowd. Love the game.
Hawaii trying to protect this house. 23 serving 22.
Important to keep the ball in after a timeout.
See if Rosen takes a little office or if he puts heat. Oh, jump float. He's going to keep it in for sure.
Vega two-hands it. Backside set. It's Jones blocked. Enriquez keeps it alive. Jones a second time. Dug up by Stein. Over the net and in.
That was a weird play. That was straight, to say the least.
And a 3-0 run prompting Aloha Ball and this boisterous crowd to rise to its feet. Serving for the match. Vega off the block. And it'll be an illegal back row attacker. Gabo Vega stepping on the line. And this match is over. Hawaii wins in a sweep again.
Amazing.
Vega's a back row player. He's got to take off behind the 3-meter line. You'll see he takes the serve. Watch him where his feet are. There's the left foot clearly on the 3-meter line. He's a back row player. He cannot step in front of that line or even on that line if you're a back row attacker.
So Hawaii takes it. Kahi Elua Aloha. 25, 22, 17, and 22. They have now tied the program record with 29 straight set victories. They have won 14 straight matches. The home winning streak, which dates back to last year, now increases to 18. And Hawaii, most importantly, now 19-2 overall this season, 9-2, and keeping pace with the big boys at the top of the MPSF standings. Take a look at the Bank of Hawaii players of the match. Gabo Vega for Stanford in his homecoming. The Kailua kid and Iolani grad, 11 kills, hitting 500 with an ace and two digs. And SVT was a monster tonight, 21 kills, hitting 515. The Flying Dutchman adding three blocks and three digs. But Hawaii victorious in sweeping fashion again. The streak rolls on. Scott Robbs has Charlie Wade.
Thanks, you know, the streak does roll on. Coach, you guys really got challenged tonight, but you answered the call every time your back was against the wall.
Yeah, super proud of the guys, how we battled there late in sets, you know, and that's kind of been the trademark of this team lately. We've played well. We were not very crisp offensively. You know, Jennings was out of practice this week with some illness, and it looked like it. We weren't that efficient offensively, but again, proud of guys, got it out, a nice win against a quality team.
How do you describe the value of Stein von Tilburg, or can you?
Well, at this point, I think he's absolutely play of the year candidate. You know, I mean, he's hitting 40%, and I mean, just he's played great in every phase of the game, and literally, you know, one of the best players in the country right now.
All right, you rematch tomorrow, so you don't have much time to think about this one. What are some of the things you'd like to clean up tomorrow night?
Well, like I said, I think offensively, you know, we'd like to get in a little more rhythm. I didn't think we were very good at that tonight. And really just hit some balls out of bounds. We're a little too terminal when we didn't need to be. So, like I said, short turnaround, and hope we get a nice crowd out here tomorrow night. It's a lot of fun.
Free tacos tonight again, Coach. Thanks.
No problem. Thanks.
All right, guys, back to you.
Yeah, putting Jack in the Box out of business with this win streak here. Charlie Wade celebrating the victory for Hawaii. All right, C-Mac, let me give you the final thoughts here. Hendrick Mohl on his birthday gets a victory. All the streaks continue. But this one, they had to overcome a little bit of adversity. They were pushed to the limits, at least more so than they have over the course of this winning streak,
yeah,
for sure.
They really were, for sure. But, you know, Charlie Wade said, you know, we got to clean things up offensively. Well, they only hit like 370 tonight. Their average for the year is like 320, so 50 points higher. I'd like to see how the offense is going to be tomorrow night. Are they going to hit 400, which is like ungodly? So, you know, we'll see what happens if they do play better tomorrow. You know, Jennings Franciscovich was missing this week in two key practices, and so that's why I think Charlie Wade thought that the offense wasn't as sharp, but I didn't think it was that bad. I'll take 370 any night.
And they pull off a sweep against the always difficult Stanford Cardinal. Don't forget about the post-game show, and if you have an opportunity, remember the clock is ticking. Only three regular season home matches remaining. This is a team worthy of in-person support. We promise you won't be disappointed. It's a fun time. For Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. See you tomorrow, everybody. Again, post-game show coming up. Until then, we bid you aloha.